It was a lot of fun. I told our guys the same message I told you guys before the game. At the end of the day, nobody knows how hard those guys are working. Every shoot around, every practice, before shoot around, before practice, after shoot around, in the summertime, and nobody knows except for the guys in the locker room. And we've kind of been searching, starting with me, different lineups, different guys, different this, different that, and everybody in that locker room has stayed patient. But watching these guys work every day and watching their togetherness, you just have a feeling that we're going to have a chance at this thing. And not for the short term, but for the long term. And so to get a win against obviously a good team like that, it's well coached, got a lot of respect for Spo. Even though I used to kick his ass back in college, he was at University of Portland when I was at USD, and neither team was good, but we were better than them. But he's done a fantastic job, and so for our guys to get a win, especially when they turned it up the way that they did and brought a physicality to the game that most teams would have folded against, was a lot of fun to watch. I got to take my hat off first to Trey Lyles. Trey stayed ready. He was big for us tonight. That rebound, loose ball was huge. Defensively, he was great. And he stepped in and let that thing go when he was open like he's supposed to. So he was big for us tonight. I also think Harrison was huge. Harrison might only score 11 points, but if you look at the plus minus, I think he was the biggest at plus 12. But more importantly, he had 6 assists. He got off the ball when he needed to and got everybody involved and kept our offense flowing. Kevin, obviously, shot the ball well. Everybody will see that. He made 7 threes, but I was just as impressed as with his ability to get his teammates involved as well. He had 6 assists. And lastly, and I can go down the line, but the last guy that I want to mention is Foxy. Here's a point guard that, in my opinion, is a winner. And he's a winner at the highest of high levels. And hopefully he'll get a chance with this team to show it to you guys, because for a point guard to come up with 13 rebounds in a physical game like this versus a really good team, it's athletic, tough, well-coached. That's special. That takes a lot of heart and determination to go in there play after play after play, especially guarding somebody on the perimeter, and then grab 13 boards to top it off. So a whale of a game from him.
Yeah, Mike, first up, congrats on
your
first win. When you look at the performance by Fox, you've said it many times, you know he's a 30-point scorer. He can put that up, but he has to do other things. Is this what you're sort of pointing to, the 13 rebounds, the big night?
100%. And I told him this. I'm going to stay on him. I'm going to keep coaching him. I'm going to keep it real with him. If I didn't think he couldn't do it, then, I might not push him as hard, because there's some things that some guys may or may not be able to do, and you try to push them, and if they don't do it, you just kind of live with it and maybe look to make a sub or get somebody else out there that can do that. But I'm telling you, as quick, strong, athletic, tough as he is, the sky's the limit. And he scratched the surface of the sky a little bit tonight with the 13 rebounds.
Mike, congrats on your first win. Give us an idea of the mood in the room back there, just how much maybe just this first one helped to break the ice and alleviate some of that pressure we talked about earlier.
It's great. Everybody's excited, like they should be, because, again, like I said, it's a really good team. You got to give that team a lot of credit for where they are as a group. And so for us to get a win against that group, especially after starting 0-4, was fantastic. Everybody feels good about it. But like I said this before the game, we were 0-4, and And I know it's hard. It's hard for people to believe what I'm saying. I still felt we were trending up. You know, we dipped maybe a little bit in our last game, but again, maybe I had something to do with that, with the subs and all that other stuff in the rotation. But I do. I like the direction that this team is going. And I told the team the same message that I told you guys before. I said, hey, as long as we can walk off that court and say that we competed as close to 48 minutes as we could, we're going to live with the results. Because if we do that with this group, we're going to win a lot more than we lose.
Mike, Tyler Hero had it going in the fourth quarter, and then I counted four possessions after that that De'Aaron guarded him 0-for-3, three contested shots, and a push-off offensive foul. Did he ask for that assignment? Did you assign him that assignment? And what are your thoughts on how he took that challenge?
No, he wanted the assignment. You know, he definitely wanted the assignment. And that's part of what I said before. You know, Tyler Hero's a great player. And, you know, he's got a lot of bags, a lot of tricks in his bag, you know. And for Foxy to do what he did down the stretch against him and then do what I'm asking him to do offensively to generate points and good looks for us was tremendous. But I'm telling you, is the more he gets put in those situations with an opportunity to win the game, in my opinion, that's the more you're going to see him step up in a lot of different areas so people can understand that he's got a complete game. At the end of the day, the only thing, in my opinion, that should hold him back from being an all-star is if our record's not good enough at that time, you know. But he's going to fight, and we're going to push him to continue to play, to continue to try to play at the highest of high levels because he's more than capable.
Coach Brown, I'll say it again because, you know, Keegan was talking about it too. You know, in that last 5.5 minutes, it's basically about stops, free throws, and execution. But and Fox was in the mix of everything.
Yeah.
But his defense, notably his defense, and I'm just piggybacking off of what Matt said, that's trending too because that was a pretty impressive defensive play that he did on had on Hera in that possession. But just talk about his defense and how he has responded, you know, to your system, and he's improving it each and every game.
No, he is. And again, I'll say this till I'm blue in the face. Everybody in that locker room, they've been working their tails off, obviously including Fox, off season, during the season, and it was good to get a win because it showed you guys and the fans that they are working and we are trending the right way. So to get wins while we're going through this is big, just to let everybody know that it's going to be okay, you know, at the end of the day. But defensively, anything he does, it doesn't surprise me because I said this, I think when I took the job, I coached him in a high school camp at an Adidas Nations. And I thought that first was going to be his superpower. Vivek, you know, he tells me this guy's got this superpower, that guy's got that superpower. And at first I was like, man, that's kind of corny, B. But now that I think about it and I use that now, I'm like, okay, well, yeah, this guy, that's his superpower. And so you let him play to his whatever his superpower is. I thought Foxy, his superpower was going to be on the defense end of the floor, you know, back in high school because he was that good at that camp. And so I'm going to push him to continue to take that challenge on. But, you know, again, you got a lot of respect for Tyler Hero and everybody in that Miami Heat locker room. But if and when he decides to sit down and guard, he could be one of the best. Eating cookies.
You and me both.
Fair enough.
When you look at you talked about in the previous game about how the 0-4 start, you know, adversity, you're going to see how this team responds. And here they even get more adversity with the, you know, foul trouble. Domas goes out that third quarter, physicality. Just what did this team show you how they kind of answered the bell as a team?
You basically answered your question. They showed a lot because – yeah, there are plenty of times that we could have folded, but I continue to press upon this group is we can make our own way. No matter what's in front of us, we're that deep and we can be that good. I do feel like we're deep, but we can be that good. We can't have anything in front of us and use it as an excuse. From the officials to foul trouble to this to that, no. Let's go earn our way. And once we earn our way, now hopefully we'll get the respect that we deserve from everybody that we play, the officials, the fans, you guys, and all that other stuff. So this group, they were fantastic because, like you said, there were a lot of adverse situations that we faced in that second half. And we could have easily said, hey, we had a great first half. We're trending in the right way. We're boom, 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 which I would have said because it is correct, and you guys felt it. We had a good first half, played the right way. But at the end of the day, we didn't let any of those things in front of us affect us, and we got to win.
You mentioned the adversity. In the third quarter, you had, I think it was 9 turnovers and 10 fouls. What were you thinking in that moment, and was your frustration building? And do you have to impress on your team that, you know, you got to clean those things up on nights where you don't shoot 45% from three?
No, my thing with our guys was we just got to keep hitting singles, you know, because Miami, they're an aggressive team. And they're an experienced championship-level team that's well-coached. And so they just, you know, they're going to play harder. That's what when you're in a tough predicament, you have to put your hard hat on and work harder than what you were doing previously. They understand that. They know that. And that's what they did. And so instead of us trying to hit home run plays, throwing a lob to a guy rolling or penetrating too deep, hey, just get off it early. Because when you face teams that are over-aggressive at times, they'll overcommit to the ball a lot of times. So that means somebody's going to be open. And if you get off the ball in a timely manner, somebody else may now commit to the ball, and that's where that next single happens, and then you knock down a shot. And so for us offensively, you know, what I kept telling the guys was, hey, hit singles, hit singles, hit singles. We don't need a home run. We don't need a triple. Shoot, we don't even need a double. You know, just pass the ball to the next open guy, and the dominoes will fall. And when they fall, good things are going to happen for us. And so I thought we pressed a little bit too much, and I thought we felt that, you know, we can make great plays to get to stop their run. And once our guys understood that, hey, it's about hitting just the next open man and letting each other play for each other and keep the floor space, we'll be all right. Once they figure that out, we were good offensively.
My name is Chris, though, so you're right. That first one is always big, but is it even bigger that it wrapped up a homestand and gives you a little bit of momentum heading into this road trip?
Yeah, I really didn't think of it that way. It's just trying to get a win, and doesn't matter when it comes. But obviously, you know, getting a win at home, knowing we had a few home games so that the fans can feel it and they can see that we're trending the right way as a group, it's good. And hopefully we can have some carryover going on this road trip.
Yeah, Coach talked a little bit about attacking mismatches pregame. How do you feel like you guys did with that specifically when it comes to Domas and making that entry pass?
One thing we can do, we can get a little bit better feeding the posts at times. You know, sometimes our angles aren't great when we feed the posts. But, you guys did a great job trying to take advantage of a defender that we felt we had an opportunity to score on, or at least make a play against. And so our guys, again, I take my hat off to our guys because they tried to move the ball, they tried to play the right way, and at the end of the day, they did try to hit an open teammate. Thank you, guys.